All right. Peace, love. This is psychedelic. Ooh, you all look really far out. Come on, Dad, please? Young Sam Yasker had some work to do, convincing his father, Max, to host a small music festival on the family farm. Reluctantly, Max Yasker agreed. What can he say to the kid? Little did the Yaskers know they would be hosting one of the most important musical events of all time, which became known simply as Woodstock, or Woodstock. Woodstock, where music, sex, drugs, politics, and religion all merged and swirled into a purple haze that came to represent the rebellious voice of a new generation, a voice that called out and sang for sexual freedom, gender equality, political responsibility, and personal liberty. Woodstock was where love was free. Well, sometimes I charged once in a while, that's another story. Love was free, minds were expanded, new ideas were born, and where some of us in this room may have been conceived, you know what I'm saying? But really, Woodstock, it was about the music. While we remember Janis and Jimmy, The Who and The Dead, there was actually a broad repertoire of music performed that weekend, from the songs of Sha-na-na to the Star-Spangled Banner, from When the Saints Go Marching In to this seemingly misplaced but altogether appropriate Gershwin classic.